Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I want to share with you this news that happened last week, and this is from Burkina Faso, where the young people stood up against the French army. And this has happened many times in the last couple of months, but finally this is getting some international news coverage. Now firstly, let's look how the French reacted to this and then we will comment. But before we get started, please remember to subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you very much.
Now, one of the destinations for these goods. Now, if we look at the map here and we can see the city of Kaya, north of Ouagadougou, that's the sticking point.
Well, yeah, and I can tell you that we have some talk with the heads of the military, French military in Paris, and they take it extremely seriously because it's a very volatile situation. It's like a nightmare scenario. Look what we're talking about and what we have, the situation we have now is, as you said, is a 60 to 90 trucks convoy coming from Ivory Coast, transiting to Burkina Faso, going to Niger, and going to Gao, where we have been spending a few days last week, and it was stopped by some hundreds of very, very furious mobs carrying anti-French slogan, and it's quite a situation now. So now
let's talk about those slogans for a second, right? Because we heard, for instance, the accusation that the French are in bed with the jihadists. Where does that come from?
Well, we went to a very blurred situation and go to the next level of a very strong information war, if I may say.
Between who and who?
Well, this is the $1 million question. And when you ask the French military, they don't name name, but basically what we have been experiencing in Bangui, in the Central African Republic, in Chad, is the same. The Russians are maneuvering. They just try to fill the gap of the French, as you said.
Why did they think that the French army was in bed with a terrorist? Well, because there have been many reports and many times the French army has been caught giving weapons to the terrorist. They are arming the terrorist. So of course, they are in bed with the jihadists. As long as there are jihadists there, the French have an opportunity to stay there. So everybody knows that the French are in bed with the jihadists. This is a well-known fact. And I like the way the guy was like, oh, how did they get that impression? It's a fact. Get over it. A couple months ago, there was the French ex-soldier who was caught giving guns and weapons to terrorists. You know? And then there was the coup that happened, and it was ex-French legionnaire. So we all know what French is doing there. And then they tried to blame the Russians. Yo, this is just the information war. The Russians are, you know, they are putting fake news out there. This has nothing to do with the Russians. We all know what the French has been doing in Africa for hundreds of years now. But this generation of young people are not like the old generation of Africans. These young people, we do not care about the French, and we will not stand for this nonsense anymore. So the young people are standing up, and it was young people who were demonstrating. They weren't paid. They were there because they wanted to see what the French were doing in their country. And this is their country, so they have the right to do that. And it's about time that the French soldiers leave. It is clear now that no one wants you there. So just take your bags and go home. No one wants you. And you can act as if you are doing something good, but we all know what you are doing. I just wanted to share with you this clip, because they are acting still, till this day, they're acting as if they are the good guys. Till this day, they're acting as if they're doing good to Africa. Please, pack your bags and go home. Now, I just wanted to share this little clip with you. I hope you enjoyed it. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, and comment. Thank you very much.